Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Today, a spring training matchup between the New York Mets and the Washington Nationals. Standing in, Amed Rosario. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 2-2. A very fine afternoon for baseball. 67 degrees here at first pitch. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone. So one away here with the bases empty. And into bat next will be J.D. Davis. Fouled off. And the slider gets him swinging. Two gone. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring in Jeff McNeil. Slapped hard the opposite way. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
The first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Into the box now, Pete Alonso. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's one and two.
Hey, I know we're only in the top of the first, but back-breaking blows are those two-out runners in scoring position knocks, and they have a chance to capitalize right here.
And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Now at the plate, Trey Turner. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1 home.
I got to count 2-2.
Weak grounder back to the mound. Now a throw over. Runner back safely. At the plate now, Adam Eaton. Turner's on his horse on his way to second. After it is Mariznick. He's there and records the first out. So a runner at first with one out now. And stepping in is the second baseman, Howie Kendrick. Throw over to the bag, and he's back standing. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. That's off the end of the bat foul, and he might have been fortunate to stay alive that time. The 2-2 one more time. Is swung on and missed. He got him. Juan Soto to the plate now. Lifetime numbers against Steven Matz. He's done well. 6-for-13. The 1-1. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Here's a look over to first. Turner, the runner at first with two gone. And another throw over, keeping particularly close tabs on him. Three balls and a strike to the Nationals left fielder. Ryan Zimmerman would be next. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Cespedes is there. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Now to the plate, Michael Conforto. He'll get us started in the top of the second. 1-1. misses for the second ball. Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning. Coming to the plate now, Yoenis Cespedes. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. He's set. Here's the 3-2. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. Oh, and this ball is absolutely blasted. High and deep. And it's gone. To the plate now, Jake Mariznick. Counts even a 2-2 to Mariznick.
The struggles continue, but that happens when you're not able to locate your secondary pitches and become a one-pitch pitcher. He needs to start to get those secondary pitches over really fast.
Boy, not close again. His third walk of the inning as that misses for ball four. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Steven Matz, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. The 1-1 pitch. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground. The 2-2 is going to be a sacrifice attempt as he gets it down. Only play to the pitcher covering, and the runner moves into second on the play. And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Amed Rosario, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. J.D. Davis now the next at bat. 0-1 here in the early going.
J.D. Davis.
Swing and a ball pulled hard down the line and left. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. And now it'll kick around in the corner.
The batter, number 6.
Stepping in now, Jeff McNeil. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. Castro is there, and he puts it away to stop the bleeding. Striding in now for the Nats, Ryan Zimmerman. And they've got some work to do early on, down 4-0 already.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning. Into the box, Kurt Suzuki. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Hit hard on the ground to second, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
That is set. The third baseman.
In now, Starlin Castro. Looked like the sinker there, dipped a little below the knees. Count is even at 2-2 to Starlin Castro.
Hey, I get where he's going right there. Sinker, and then pull the string back a little bit with that nasty changeup. But if those fall in the...
Oh, and he has some trouble with it. The throw pulls the first baseman off the bag. Now everybody's going to be safe. Bases full now following the error. And digging in is the outfielder, Eric Thames. Ground ball to second. This could be two. To second for one. On to first to complete the double play. So a man at third here with two gone. And that'll bring up one of the better hitting pitchers in Max Scherzer. The 1-1. In the air now out to left. Cespedes is there. And the inning is over. Up next, the power bat of Pete Alonso. 0 for 1 for him here in this one.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
2-1.
I got 2-1 to count.
Strike two called, and it's even at two.
Of course, there was a fastball.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. At the plate, Michael Conforto. Conforto behind, a ball and two strikes. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. A shot down the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. He reached on a walk in his last time up and later came around to score. Hit the target, but this is low. 2-1.
One strike.
Oh, look at that stop. And he'll flip it onto first, and with it, that ends the inning. The speedy Trey Turner digs in now as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. In now is Adam Eaton. 4-1's our score here in inning number three. Grounded to short. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first. And now for Washington, Howie Kendrick was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Lifted in the air to center field. Mariznick will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Next for the Mets, Yoenis Cespedes. He went deep in his first at-bat, and we'll see what he's got in store for us here. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now, 3-2.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. Four runs through three innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now.
You rarely see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle, and man, as a hitter, probably a good chance you're not going to see that pitch again.
Soto is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. So here now is the pitcher, Steven Matz. He successfully laid down a sack bunt in his last plate appearance.
And not easy to do in today's game. High velocity, exploding breaking stuff. He executed that sack bunt perfectly.
Popped up. Off balance throw gets him. Nice play there as the side is retired. Here now is Juan Soto. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Hit hard on the ground towards second. Scooped up. Throw on to first in time. One away. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the power hitting first baseman Ryan Zimmerman. The 1-1. One run on three hits and no errors so far for the Nationals. Two balls and two strikes, the count to Ryan Zimmerman. Line drive, base hit. So now to the plate, Kurt Suzuki. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Swinging a soft liner. He lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right.
Now back, the third baseman.
At the plate, Starlin Castro. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
3-1 to him now. High in the air and deep to straightaway left. Cespedes is going back to the track, but he won't get there as it lands just shy of the wall. The runner scores from second. Late now, Eric Thames. Line drive to center field. Dive, but it's off his glove, and that ought to get at least one run in. On to third, but he's in safely as they also push across a score to make it a one-run game. Asdrubal Cabrera will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Still only one out in the inning. Hit back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. So two are gone now in the Nationals' fourth. And that'll bring up one of the fastest players in all the land, Trey Turner. 2-1, the count to Trey Turner.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
And it's two balls and two strikes now. Hit sharply on the ground. Throw on to first, and they're able to escape the monster inning as the side is retired. Will Crow, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 57. Will.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Ahmed Rosario, 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a liner. Foul. Skied in the air to straightaway left. And this is going to be extra bases here to kick off the fifth. Around second. He's on his way to third. Stepping in now, J.D. Davis. To two balls and two strikes now.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
Into center field, line drive, base hit. And the runner from third crosses the plate. It's a 5-4 game.
The batter, number 5.
Into the box, Jeff McNeil. And that misses for ball 4. And it's first and second now with nobody out.
Up next to the net.
So here's Pete Alonso. The 3-1. And he lays off there, ball 4. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out. Into the box now, Michael Conforto. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at-bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And a swing and a miss on a huge first out there as he sets him down swinging with the bases loaded. Five runs, 5 hits, and 2 errors for the Mets so far. Oh, here's a drive into the gap in right center as he comes through with extra bases. One run is scored. It's cut off, so all 3 runners are in to score. Eric Fetty, 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching. Into the box now, Yoenis Cespedes. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. As he arrives at second without a play, as a run will score on the play as well. In now, Jake Mariznick. A ball and 2 strikes now. And this is pulled fouled as he was way out in front there. Liner towards second. And that's in there. Base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only 1 away.
Now back. The pitcher.
Now a move over to first. And he's back easily. At the plate, Steven Matz. On the ground to Kendrick. This might be 2. The tag gets 1. Relay to Zimmerman. The double play to end the inning. Adam Eaton digging in next. 0-for-2 with a fly ball and a ground out on his line to this point.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the 8th and 9th inning.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Adam Eaton is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. 3-1 to Howie Kendrick. Juan Soto is on deck. Here's the 2-seam fastball that bears in a bit too tight. It's ball 4. So next will be the 4-hole for the Nationals. Juan Soto. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Hit sharply on the ground. And that's through for his first base hit in this one. Standing in now, Ryan Zimmerman. Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble, 3-1.
We're starting to see a lot more balls from him now, and that's a direct result of him getting hit around pretty good. He's trying to do something different, and it's resulting in him not attacking the strike zone anymore.
And the recovery won't be in time as he'll beat the throw to first. So now to the plate, Kurt Suzuki. An even 2-2 count to the Nationals catcher. And this misses, so it'll set up a big pitch coming up. It's full, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Franklin Killamer is called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Line to the right side, but that's a foul ball.
He was looking for a swing and a miss breaker right there, but left that one in the zone that got fouled off.
The next 1-2 pitch. Well outside with the curveball for a ball.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And it'll be a sac fly and an RBI, as that'll cut this to a 3-run deficit now. So it's first and second with two men gone. And in steps the lefty power threat, Eric Thames. Now the 1-1 pitch. Leaps and makes a terrific catch. And with that, the side is retired. Now back to the top of the lineup. Stepping in, Amed Rosario. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. The 2-1 home. Line drive to center field. Eaton is there, and he has it for the first out. One away now for the Mets in the sixth, and into bat next will be J.D. Davis. Bases are empty, one man out. Towards second, and this will be put away easily for the out. So here's Jeff McNeil. He doubled earlier in the game, 1-for-2 to this point. The 1-1 home. He's outside for a ball. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now. Pitch on the way. Soft liner to the left side. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Victor Robles is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number 6.
Victor Robles.
And he misses 2-1. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the 9-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball 4 to start the bottom of the 6th. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And in the bat is Trey Turner. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Got to believe the pitcher's going to trust his defense right here. Look for something down in his zone to induce a ground ball double play.
2-2.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Curveball, and he buckled him, but it's full 3-2. Adam Eaton is on deck. He'll hit next. Line towards center field. And that's in there. Base hit. Into the box, Adam Eaton. And a fastball down low as that one just about got away from him.
That's a classic piece of pitching right there. You have to back hitters away from the plate to make them a little bit uncomfortable. Now you can go inside or outside. I like that purpose pitch.
And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out. To the plate now, Howie Kendrick. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
Hey, that's the kind of swing you'd like to see a guy take with the bases loaded. He's going for the downs.
Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. Catch is made. Here comes the runner from third. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third. Steven Gonsalves.
Comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, man. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
The 2-1 on its way. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit in now. 3-1, 2-on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
Called strike, and that'll run it full. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Stepping in, Ryan Zimmerman, trying to keep it going. A perfect 3-for-3 thus far. 1-1. Takes a pitch for strike number two.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive in a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
Ball two. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full. 3-2. Kurt Suzuki would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Now a ball lined toward the alley in left center. And this is going to be his fourth hit of the game, as this should wind up as extra bases. He pulls into second safely, as we're now tied after a pair of runs score on the play.
Now
in now, Kurt Suzuki. 1-1 pitch is a curveball that misses ball two. All even now, 2-2. Three runs already home here. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. Austin Voss is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Robinson Cano is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number seven. Fouled away. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Into center field. Line drive base hit. He's around first, heading for two. Around second is Cano, headed for third. And he will make it in safely. He's in at third as the go-ahead run. Eduardo Nunez will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot.
Eduardo Nunez.
Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with nobody out. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Voss stands 6-2 and throws from the right side. He was a fifth-round pick back in the draft of 2013.
Hey, nothing has been handed to this guy. Drafted in the middle rounds, and he has found his way into big leagues. This has turned out to be a really nice pick.
Outside in a full count, 3-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And a swing and a miss. He struck him out, and the go-ahead run stays at third with one big out on the scoreboard now. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. A bouncer up the middle. And that is through for a base hit. And the move to the bench will pay off handsomely. Notch one in the score column as the runner from third crosses the plate. Stepping in now, Yoenis Cespedes. Good plate discipline to lay off the slider that time, and he draws even a 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. Working for the punch out and the offering. Slapped hard the opposite way. Thames is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Next up from New York, Jake Mariznick. He singled his last time up. Three and one now as that misses down and in.
I'm seeing him aim the ball right now. That's a trap you fall into as a pitcher when you're not as confident in your stuff as you should be. You got to trust your stuff.
And the Mets just keep right on rolling as this is good for extra bases as well. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double. Andres Jimenez will grab a bat to pinch hit, and he'll do so with a couple of runners in scoring position here, but with two out in the inning. Second and third, two away. On the ground up the middle. And that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. Daniel Hudson will get the ball here as he looks to get the final out in the top of the seventh. Dominic Smith will look for some two-out magic here as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at first. Two out with the man at first. Runners off for second. Pitch outside. The throw is not going to get him as he swipes second. To 2-2 now. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2 one more time. Left side, but well fouled. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Turned on down the line. Fielded cleanly by Zimmerman. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Paul Sewald gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 51, Paul Sewald.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Striding in once again, Starlin Castro. It was an RBI sack fly for him last time through. And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1, Sewald. A Nevada native, he was taken in the 10th round during the first-year player draft of 2012.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
And he will make the nice running catch out there as he had to travel a long distance to rein that one in. Into the box now, Eric Thames. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the 3-2 pitch. Is swung on and missed. He got him. Wilmer Defoe will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded to third. Davis grabs it cleanly, and that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Wander Suero has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Brandon Nimmo is going to be asked to get things going here as a leadoff the top of the eighth. Cut fastball that time, but he doesn't bite, and now it's 3-1. Jeff McNeil waits on deck. Line down the left field line, but this is foul near the seats. Three-two pitch. And a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning. Will Toffey come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out. A runner at first with no outs here. Popped up. Castro in foul ground, but this will land untouched. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3-2. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Nobody out, runner on first. He finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a nine-pitch at-bat. Elise Sanchez will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Right side hit hard, and that's through for a hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
The right fielder, number 12, Eduardo Nunez.
At the plate, Eduardo Nunez in there, and it's even now, 2-2. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning.
Now about it.
Standing in, Tomas Nido. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And a swing and a miss as he pulled the string on the breaking ball, and the inning is over. Dylan Betances will come on and pitch for the seventh time here this spring. Andrew Stevenson will try and get his club back into it here as he'll pinch hit to lead off the home half of the eighth. No contact there, and it's 1-2. Tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone. The 2-2. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall. And the Nationals get a man into scoring position. It's a leadoff double. Jake Knoll come off the bench now as he'll pinch hit with the runner at second and nobody out. Fouled off. The 1-2.
catches the corner, got him looking. Trace Barrera will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here as he'll pinch hit now with one away. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now. Bat explodes as this has popped up, and he'll find a way to dodge the shrapnel out there to make the play for out number two. Michael Taylor will look to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner at second and two away. And it's fouled away. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. To two balls and two strikes now. And a full count, 3-2 to Michael Taylor.
Well, the tying run looms on deck, so keeping this guy off the base is essential.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Hunter Strickland enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. All set for the start of the inning. Now at the plate, Yoenis Cespedes. It's been a 2-for-4 effort for him so far in the ballgame. The 3-2 pitch. He takes something off there as this is swung on and missed, and there's one gone here in the ninth. Here's Jake Marisnik, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. The 1-1.
Nope.
One out, nobody on. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Pulled toward right center field. And he will get there as he had to cover a lot of ground to make that play. And that ends the inning. Seth Lugo comes out of the bullpen to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 67. Seth.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. Stepping up to the plate, Ryan Zimmerman. He drove in two with a double in his last at-bat. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. So coming to the plate, Kurt Suzuki. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. Strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Last strike now for the Nats. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Cespedes is there. Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
12-9, the final in this one. New York
used a three-run seventh to help propel them to the win. Steven Gonsalves earns the victory on the mound. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.
Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 16 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.